Welcome to First Congregational Church. My name is Kevin Jones, and I serve as Minister of Music here. On behalf of the congregation, council, clergy, and staff, I welcome you here today. We are delighted to see you. It is our sincere pleasure to have as our guest artist today, Mr. Clark Wilson, known to so many of us in Central Ohio through his artistry at the Ohio Theater and many other venues locally and nationally. Congregational Concerts is supported solely through its donors and friends. It is only through your financial support that we are able to bring high-quality artists like Clark Wilson to First Church. If you would like to donate today or at any time, please go to www.concertsatfirstchurch.org/concert-offering or click on the QR code that you see on your screen and fill out the form. Thank you in advance for your support. Without further delay, please help me welcome to the First Church Movie Theater, organist Clark Wilson.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to First Congregational Church of Columbus. As we settle in and look at a famous 1927 Cecil B. DeMille biblical epic, The King of Kings, it's an ideal way and an ideal day to start this telling of the final weeks of Christ's life. This was considered possibly DeMille's finest film, although he considered others almost as good, not quite, and he continued on into the 1950s, directing a number of biblical pieces, large, large films, such as The Ten Commandments, which incidentally, H.B. Warner, who stars in this afternoon's picture, made his final appearance in as an old, old man. But he was at the top of his game when DeMille filmed this in 1927. Warner was a Shakespearean actor from England who had trod the boards of the legitimate stage in New York and lent a spectacular, spectacular image to this role of Christ. I think you'll enjoy it. There are a cast of thousands in this, and it's really a spectacular picture. There's not a lot else to really tell that you won't see with your own eyes. The score for this afternoon is based on the original that was produced by a fellow named Hugo Reisenfeld, one of the finest scorers of silent pictures at the time. There are a number of hymns and classic pieces in it, some things of which I'm sure you'll recognize. It's not all completely intact, 100%. Times have changed. Tastes have changed, the way we think has changed, and some things don't fit as well as they did in 1927. So we've re-edited bits and pieces, but we're very fortunate to have that score, that we can live this film very much like our forefathers saw and heard it when it first came out. And of course, with the spectacular, spectacular varied colors and beauty of the Kimball organ here at First Church. So without further ado, we invite you to settle back then and enjoy a magnificent start to Holy Week, Cecil B. DeMille's epic, King of Kings.